by the cosmic mercy of Srila Prabhupada, we've all got entrance into this very beautiful, wonderful tradition of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. It is very rare to get a human form, very rare. Especially a human form where we have proper mental, physical, emotional and cognitive abilities. We are not handicapped or deprived in any way. A human form where there is no deformity. A human form where we are not blind, we are not deaf, we are not dumb. Human form where we are not born orphans. A human form where we have a roof above our head, place under our feet, clothes to wear, food to eat, a school to attend, money to live with, and most importantly, people who are like-minded to keep us socially and emotionally content. It is a very, very great gift of God. Oftentimes we talk about, when is Krishna going to be merciful unto me? But the fact that we are thinking like this in itself is a symptom of His mercy. And over and above that, to get this human form with all these wonderful abilities, capabilities, and to have some faith in the Almighty is even more rare to find in Brahma's creation. Now, among all those who believe in a higher power, those who believe in the personality instead of the formless feature of God, that in itself is another great benediction. There are so many people who believe in a superpower, but they have no clue whom they are believing in. God is light, God is formless, God is present everywhere, I have nothing to do with Him. But when we have a very wonderful feature, a personality, a name, a form, beauty, qualities, activities, a place where He resides, the abode, His paraphernalia, His associates, now we have the heart, some juice to get attracted to. Over and above that, to be attracted to Vishnu and not some mere mortal of this world, some babas of this world, some duplicate, fake it till you make it, gurus of this world. To be really, really attracted to Vishnu. Now we are sitting on the top of the icing of the cake of Brahma's creation. And now, instead of being attracted to just the four-handed form of Vishnu, to be attracted to the two-handed form of Krishna, that's like sitting on top of the cherry of the icing of the cake. But interestingly, you could be attracted to Krishna even in Dwarka, as the king of Dwarka, along with Rukmini and Satyabhama and Jambavati. But to be attracted to Krishna in Vrindavan, now you're talking about a transcendental cake altogether. And that too, to be attracted to Krishna in Vrindavan, in the association of Srimati Radharani, where He's so beautiful that millions and billions of cupids can fall dead looking at His beauty. That is Radha Madan Mohan.
Hare Krishna.
And now, to go even further and to say, when Radha and Krishna are together and their beauty and sweetness multiplies and goes into layers and layers of intimacies, of union, mysteries of union and separation, that Krishna now desires to become Radhika and comes down as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. I can't even describe if it's still in part of the cake. It's something else. And Srila Prabhupada walked on this world gifting Gaur Nithai to those who had no clue what they are looking for in life. Srila Prabhupada introduced a very beautiful plan of gifting Gaur Nithai dolls to people on the street. And it had a very nice message. It had an incense stick inside. A nice, cute Gaur Nithai doll. It's like a $5 pack. With an incense stick inside. And the message said, just light this stick and keep waving around these dolls. They bring in fortune and prosperity. And people on the street taking the incense stick out of that godly type box and lighting it up and waving. This was never seen, never heard, never conceived. But this happened because of Srila Prabhupada. But interestingly, as we see, we are under the shade of Srila Prabhupada, who is like the mature fruit of the tree of Gaudiya Vaishnavism. But this fruit of Srila Prabhupada completely got fructified by the seed of Bhakti Siddhanta. If not for Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, we wouldn't have had our Srila Prabhupada. But interestingly, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur is also the matured fruit of the seed of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. So today, for the pleasure of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, I will glorify his Gurudev. Because on any Avirbhava or Tirobhava, appearance or disappearance, we end up glorifying the Vaishnava, which is the tradition. But in a birthday celebration, do you give the birthday boy the gift of your choice or the gift of his choice? The gift of his choice. And the gift that Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur aspires as a disciple to hear is not his glory, but the glory of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj in connection with him. How wonderfully he is inheriting the legacy of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. That is true glorification. Oftentimes people say Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was so illiterate that he could never sign. But I would like to humbly propose something. That Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj gave an immortal sign to this world. The signature of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Every single thing that Saraswati Thakur did had the underlying signature of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji. We will see how. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, he appeared in a Vaishya family, in a family of grain merchants. And as he appeared, Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was given the name Vamshi. What was his name?
Vamshi.
He was as attractive as Krishna's flute. And as we know, the tradition used to be such that they would get the children married off really quick. So early in his life, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj went through Vivaha Samskar. He got married. And not many devotees know this, that for 29 years, he lived in household life. Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj lived as a sadgrihastha 29 years in his life. But then, as his wife departed from this world, he took Babaji Vesh, which means the vow of renunciation, the vow of poverty, the vow of complete destitute dependence on Krishna. And he took this vow of Babaji initiation from Bhagavad Das Babaji Maharaj. From whom?
Bhagavad Das Babaji.
And Bhagavad Das Babaji Maharaj was the direct Diksha disciple of Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. So beautiful. So beautiful. He took Diksha and for 30 years entered the groves of Vrindavan and chanted Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare After 29 years of family life, 30 years in Vrindavan, constantly chanting day and night, crying and weeping. But after that, in 1893, very interesting, in the year 1893, Bhaktivinod Thakur, he established the Gaura Avir Bhavasthana, which means the birthplace of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by the wonderful direction of Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. So for that celebration, Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj came from Vrindavan to Navadvip to see the Gaura Avir Bhav Sthan, the appearance place of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And when he came there, he met with Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj, his Param Gurudev, the spiritual master of Bhagavad Das Babaji Maharaj. And Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj met Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, looked into his eyes, and in the first meeting said, how is your Harinam Bhajan going? How is Vrindavan? Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was crying and weeping, saying, I have no taste in chanting the holy name. So when devotees ask, How are you doing, Prabhu? The answer is, Prabhu, my chanting is not going good. I am not able to chant the way I am supposed to. I am not able to serve the Vaishnavas the way I am supposed to. I have plans to read Srila Prabhupada's books, but somehow I fall asleep every time I open. This is my destitute condition. If you really want to know how I am doing, this is my condition. So Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj's eyes lit up when Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj gave him his instruction. He said, my instruction for you is leave Vrindavan and come to Navadvip. For those who have no hope in the age of Kali Yuga, even Vrindavan takes a longer time, but Navadvip gives mercy quickly. Panchatattvatmakam gauram Krishna Chaitanya samyakam ye bhajante Navadvipe teme priyakhilamata. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said, those who chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra living in Navadvip Dham, New Pani Hati Dham. Those who chant Harinam in Navadvip, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, I give them my supreme mercy. So Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj told Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, and Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj at once left Vrindavan and came to Navadvip. And when he came to Navadvip, the symptoms of renunciation that he was exemplifying in this world was unparalleled. Nama Gaura Kishoraya Sakshad Vairagya Murtaye. Sakshad Vairagya Murtaye. He was the embodiment of supreme renunciation. Prapanchikataya Buddhya Hari Sambandhi Vastutaha Mumukshi Bhi Parityago Vairagyam Phalbukatyate Anasaktasya Vishayan Yathartham Upayunjataha Nirbandha Krishna Sambande Yukta Vairagya Muchyate Vasudeve Bhagavati Bhakti Yoga Prayojitaha Janayityasu Vairagyam Jnanam Yachya Ahaitukam Vairagya Yug Bhakti Rasam Prayatnai Apaya Yanma Mana Vipsumandham Kripam Budhiya Paradukha Dukhi Sanatanam Prabhu Vashraya. Rup Goswami, first two verses, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Second verse, Bhagavatam, first canto, second chapter. Third verse, Raghunath Das Goswami to Sanatana Goswami. All on the theme of renunciation. Rupa Goswami says, those who worship Sri Hari with one-pointed attention and affection, they develop true renunciation. Everyone else is simply a pretender. I will not touch this. I will not wear this. In fact, Srila Prabhupada went against this principle. One time, one disciple came to Srila Prabhupada and said, there is this sadhu here who doesn't even look at money. When you give money, oh, he clicks his pictures like this. Srila Prabhupada said, oh, when that money has got to me, I will click pictures like this. So all the disciples were baffled. What is this? A sadhu, a monk is supposed to be detached from money. What is this? Embracing money? Prabhupada explained. When there are some bills on the floor, there are three kinds of responses. The first response is, you look to the right, you look to the left, and you see there's no one around. And if it's not anyone who's coming around claiming his bill, then it's mine. The second response, it's not mine, so I don't care, I just walk past. And the third, he picks up the bills of money, looks around, cries loudly to say, is there anyone who has lost his money? Please come and take it. Prabhupada gave these three scenarios and asked his disciples, which among them is first class? They all unanimously said the third one. The third response, where you offer it back to the person who has lost it. Prabhupada said, yes. Those who don't take anything of this world are like the second example. Those who take things of this world for themselves are the first example. And for those who see that the world belongs to Sri Krishna and he in the process of creation has lost it, so now it's our duty to give it back to him, is the third example. And Prabhupada said, this is why I take money to give it back. I take Lakshmi to give it back to Narayana. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj exemplified unparalleled renunciation. He lived off a boat overturned on the banks of the Ganga. He had nothing. No cloth on his body. just chanting the holy name. And that too, he had no beads. He would make 108 knots out of the cloth which was used to cover dead bodies. And he would chant on them, sitting on an overturned boat on the banks of the Ganga. So when it was extreme cold, one man came and gifted him a very opulent blanket. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj accepted and put it on top of one of the huts. The man came the other day, said, the next day, and he said, "Where's the blanket that I gave you?" He said, "It's there, on top." He said, "Why have you put there, O Babaji Maharaj?" Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, "This blanket is so opulent. Maya lives so much in this blanket that even at this distance, the blanket is invoking heat in me. It's kicking away all my cold just by looking. So it's serving the purpose. I get angry looking at the blanket." So much renunciation. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj would go door to door and beg for food. It's called Madhukari Pravritti. Like a bumblebee goes from flower to flower. He would go and he would cook on clay pots which have been thrown away by the neighbors. He would cook on them, and so that the ants don't come into those clay pots, what would he do? He would hang them up with a rope. Because you know when clay pots are hung from the ceiling with a rope, the ants can't go there. And he was sitting and chanting, but the ants didn't go there, a snake entered. A snake entered on top of the roof and through the rope entered the pot. And as the snake was in the pot, you see, the probability of snake touching and poisoning the whole thing is very high. So as soon as the snake was spotted, one lady, very wonderful hearted Mataji from the neighborhood, ran into Babaji Maharaj's kutir and said, "Babaji Maharaj, look, there is a snake in your ashram. And the snake is poisoning the food. I am scared. You will eat that food and something will happen to you." Babaji Maharaj opened his eyes and he said, "Leave at once and never return." And the lady said, "I have come here to give my affection to you, to save you from the snake bite. And you are shouting at me." Babaji Maharaj said, "It is better to die by the poison of the snake than to look at the poison of your affection. For a renunciant, it is worse than death to look eye to eye into the eye of a Mataji. Go." Very high class. Nishkinchanasya bhagavat bhajanon mukhasya param param dhigamisho bhavasagarasya sandarshanam vishayinam athayoshidanam ha hanta hanta vishabhakshana tonya mukhya. Bhagavatam describes, for someone who's a renunciant, for someone who wants Shri Hari and wants to cross this ocean of repeated birth and death, two things must be avoided. Association of those who are averse to Shri Krishna and association of women. If these two things are not avoided, ha hanta hanta vishana bhakshana, it is better to die out of poison. Because the poison separates the soul from the body, but the association of the opposite sex separates the soul from the super soul. So Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was very strict. In fact, when there used to be kirtans going on, one time there was a man who came into Babaji Maharaj's ashram and said, "Babaji Maharaj, outside your ashram, there was a 24-hour kirtan. Set of few villagers, they came together and they chanted loudly for 24 hours, so wonderful." Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, "They have polluted the land of Navadvip. They have polluted." "Why?" The man asked with shock. He said, "They chanted for 24 hours. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, "Oh, they are chanting Hare Krishna through the tongue, but their heart is chanting money, women, money, women, money, women, money, women. This is what they are chanting." "So, what to do?" said Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, "Take all that clay, all that dirt where they were dancing, take it and throw it into the Ganga to purify the land." This is how renounced he was. He was not interested in who is doing kirtan or who is doing katha. He was interested in the intention behind it. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was always very intense. And when Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur was only 11 years old, he wrote his commentary on a book called Surya Siddhanta, which explains astrology and astronomy. He was proofreading Bhaktivinoda Thakur's Jaiva Dharma at the age of 7. At the age of 15, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur was appointed the chairperson for the Department of Philosophy, Astronomy and Sanskrit by the University of Calcutta. The youngest ever in the history of the university. And in fact, it was an open chair. They told Vimal Prasad, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, that you can come in anytime, you can teach a few classes, and you can walk out anytime. This chair is reserved for you lifelong. That Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, that Vimal Prasad, who was so scholarly, he said, I have not come in this world to count the number of stars. I have come in this world to fall in love with Krishna. And he said, I am so wretched that wherever I go, I see only people as wretched as I am. So who's going to save me? But when he saw the first darshan of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, his head hit the floor in submission. And Bimal Prasad said, there was a radiating sunlight of purity from his eyes. I had no hope except his lotus feet. And he went to Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. Why? Because he was not just Sakshat Vairagya Murtaye, he was Vipralambara Sambodhe. He was drowning in the ocean of love for Krishna. Total, complete surrender. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur went to Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, Vimal Prasad, and said, I want to become your disciple. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, oh, you are so learned, you are so exalted, I don't know anything. How can I teach you something? You are more qualified. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, just like Sripad Ramanujacharya did, if my qualification and my scholarship is depriving me of taking shelter of your lotus feet, to hell with my scholarship, to hell with my learning. My only identity is I want to be your servant. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, okay, you go. I will ask Gauranga Mahaprabhu. I will talk to Gaur Nithai. And whatever they say, I will do. You go. He didn't want any disciples. If someone comes and touches the feet of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, he would say, you are doomed. You are doomed. No hope now. You are touching my feet. No hope. No disciples. So Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was very strict. He liked to be in seclusion. No disturbance. No talking with anyone. Nothing to do in this world. Bimal Prasad came back again. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, oh, I forgot to ask Gauranga. I forgot. Bimal Prasad said, oh, did you see him? Yes. I danced in the kirtan, but I forgot to ask him. So you go. I will ask him. You come back again. Again, Saraswati Thakur came. And Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, oh, don't you know? Being very learned and coming from an aristocratic family and having handsome features like this and being very wealthy, these are all disqualifications for Diksha. He said, you cannot surrender with these qualities. Go. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj's words were like a thunderbolt to the heart of Vimal Prasad. Vimal Prasad decided, history has shown proofs that even if you're rejected once, twice or thrice, don't lose hope. Somebody like Sripad Ramanujacharya was rejected 18 times by his guru Goshti Purna. 18 times, you go. No, go. And Ramanujacharya came back again and again and again. Same happened with Narottam Das Thakur and Lokanath Goswami. Lokanath Goswami said, no, I cannot accept you. You are a prince. I am a beggar. No, no, I cannot. And Narottam Das Thakur ended up serving by picking up the stool and urine of Lokanath Goswami in seclusion to serve his guru. And when Lokanath Goswami saw this, he jumped out of the grove and embraced Narottam Das Thakur and gave him love of God. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, our Vimal Prasad, thought in his heart, history has shown two rejections is nothing. I will not give up. He did something called as the austere Chandrayana Vrata. Now the Chandrayana Vrata is described in the Shastra to be a very, very austere Vrata. What does that mean? On the full moon, you eat 15 palmfuls of prasad. 15. On the full moon. Then as the moon, this waxing and waning of the moon, the 15th becomes the 14th day, so you eat only 14 palmfuls of food that day. Then 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. Then there comes a time when it's the 5th day. So you're eating only 5 palmfuls of prasad. The kids can settle a little. On the 5th day, 5 palmfuls of prasad. Then on the 4th day, 4. On the 3rd day, 3. On the 2nd day, 2. On the 1st day, 1. And then on the day of no moon, complete fast. And then you go back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 15. So 30 days you eat according to the movement of the size of the moon. This is called Chandrayan Vrat. Saraswati Thakur did this for one whole month with the Sankalpa to get the lotus feet of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. This has been the tradition. How much the disciples had to strive to get the lotus feet of a pure Vaishnava. And when we get it freely by their causeless mercy, we take them for granted. And throughout he was chanting verses from Srimad Bhagavatam and chanting the holy name. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So with this Chandrayan Vrat, we're chanting the holy name and a very strong recommendation coming from Bhaktivinod Thakur. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj finally agreed. And he told Bimal Prasad, okay, I agree. I have got order from Sachitananda Bhaktivinod Thakur. Because just before that, Bimal Prasad had also threatened suicide. He said, oh Gurudev, if you don't accept me, I will jump into the Ganga and give up my life. Amito Kangal Krishna Krishna Boli Daitava Pache Pache Jogyata Vichare Kichu Nahi Pai Tumaro Karuna Sar Karuna Na Hoile Kandiya Kandiya Pranana Rakhi Bohar. So Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, yes, tomorrow you go, you bathe in the Ganga and you come fresh. I will give you Diksha. Saraswati Thakur Bimal Prasad came. And the first thing Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj did, he who never gave his lotus feet food just to anybody, he rubbed his hand to his lotus feet and bestowed on the lotus head of Saraswati Thakur. And Saraswati Thakur describes in his writings, when I was touched by the particles of dust from the lotus feet of my Gurudev, I lost consciousness of this material world. I could realize myself to be one of those floating jivas in this insurmountable ocean of misery, and there's no one except my Gurudev who can help me. I realized all this just by the Shakti Sanchar, the infusion of empowerment coming from the beautiful, wonderful dust particles from the lotus feet of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. And Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj initiated him in the Bhagavat Parampara and gave him the name Sri Varsha Bhanavi Devi Daita Das Brahmachari. Sri Varsha Bhanavi Devi Daita Das Brahmachari Srila Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur Ki. As he was initiated and given this wonderful name, he was given the vrat of lifelong celibacy. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, whatever he held in his life, all those qualities were inherited by Saraswati Thakur. Saraswati Thakur, whatever activity he did in his life, he inherited the signature of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. He inherited the austerity of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. Following the footsteps of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, our Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur in seclusion in Mayapur chanted 1 billion names of Krishna, chanting 300,000 names every day. That is 192 rounds every day for 10 years. How much is that practically? We chant 16 rounds. Times 16 rounds every day for 10 years. And he did that in seclusion. So much so that Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was so happy, he loudly would proclaim, I see the renunciation of Raghunath Das Goswami in my Prabhu. He called his own disciple as his master, my Prabhu. And he said, I see the renunciation of Raghunath Das Goswami of Radhakund in my Prabhu. And he never associated with anyone. So the austerity of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj came into Saraswati Thakur. The devotion in chanting the holy names in seclusion came into Saraswati Thakur. The uncompromising, non-compromising spirit came into Saraswati Thakur. You see, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was cut right. Either it's right or wrong, there's no gray area. Bhaktivinoda Thakur, on the other hand, was very, very all-encompassing. He would include everyone in his writings. He would respect everyone. He would include everyone. He was one-pointed in his mood. But he would lovingly welcome everyone. This was Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So therefore, when Bhaktivinoda Thakur spoke, hundreds and thousands of people sat and heard. But as soon as Saraswati Thakur would sit, the thousand would become 100, 100 would become 10, and 10 would become 1. People would flee away. Because he was like a sword, asanga shastrena dhridena chitva. No compromise. And this was the mood of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji. Underlining signature. In fact, in 1915, it is described, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj entered a public toilet in Navadvip and he locked from within and he never came out. Why? Because people on the banks of the Ganga were troubling him. Baba, please give us your blessings. Please give us your blessings. Kripa karo, kripa karo, kripa karo. And this was a big headache for Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj. So he got into a very stinking public toilet and locked from inside so that nobody troubles him now. The village magistrate came. The chief of police, they came and they were knocking. Babaji, please come out. We will build a bhajan kutir for you. He said, no. He said, no, please come out. We'll keep it very clean. The public toilet that you're sitting in is stinking. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj said, the stink of materialistic people is more than the stink of this public toilet. I prefer this. Uncompromising. He would not open for anyone. But at that time, there was a young boy, 17-year-old, by the name Vinod Bihari, who came to Saraswati Thakur. When Saraswati Thakur was chanting, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Vinod Bihari came to Saraswati Thakur, even before sannyas. Saraswati Thakur was doing his 10 years of Naam Bhajan. And while he would chant, in the middle, when he would have ecstatic symptoms, eruptions of ecstasy, he would drop his beads and write the commentary of Manasiksha and Upadeshamrita and Chaitanya Bhagavat, so on and so forth. This is where Prabhupada inherited that the purports are my transcendental ecstasies, because he's inheriting the signature of Saraswati Thakur. So as Saraswati Thakur was chanting and writing like this, Vinod Bihari went as a young boy with his two aunts, who later on ended up being the first two female disciples of Saraswati Thakur. And Vinod Bihari went and surrendered his life. And Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur said, you want my mercy? I will give you. My Gurudev, Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, is on the planet. And he's in a public toilet chanting. You go and take his darshan. He said, but how will I have darshan? He is locked from inside. He said, don't worry. I'll give you a secret mantra in your ear. Just go and loudly chant that. Secret mantra. Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj never opened the public toilet for anyone. But when Vinod Bihari, Brahmachari came, he stood outside the door and said, oh Babaji Maharaj, we come carrying the dust from the lotus feet of Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur. And Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj opened the door, grabbed him in and locked. He opened up, grabbed him in and locked, and he said, you are coming from my Prabhu's Sangha, Amar Prabhu. Tell me, what is my Prabhu doing? And he gave so many instructions. And he told Vinod Bihari Das Brahmachari that in your life, you will face a lot of trouble. But by the mercy of chanting Harinam, all of that will be taken care of. You don't worry. This Vinod Bihari Das Brahmachari later on ended up becoming Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Maharaj, who gave sannyas to our Srila Prabhupada. So the instructions of Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, which came to Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Maharaj, were very significant, because Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Maharaj was imprisoned and arrested so many times for some uncalled for reasons. But then by chanting the holy name, he was protected. So it is so beautiful that this Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj was so absorbed that our Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur said, if I would have seen Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj chanting the holy name 23 hours, 59 minutes and 59 seconds and keeping 1 second for himself, I wouldn't have taken Diksha from him. I repeat this again. Our Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur said, if I would have seen my Gurudev Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj chant the holy name for 23 hours, 59 minutes and 59 seconds every day and keep 1 second for himself, I wouldn't have taken Diksha from him. But the fact that he was absorbed 24 hours melted my heart and I surrendered my life. So beautiful. So in this way, our Saraswati Thakur, although he quoted all the acharyas in his writings, he mainly quoted Bhakti Vinod Thakur. Bhakti Vinod Thakur was all encompassing. So he took that spirit of preaching from Bhakti Vinod Thakur, but the spirit of non-compromising attitude came from Gaur Kishore Das Babaji. Austere bhajan came from Gaur Kishore Das Babaji. Attachment to chanting the holy name came from Gaur Kishore Das Babaji. So who can say that Gaur Kishore Das Babaji could never sign? We signed so many documents to show our proof. But Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj's signature was Saraswati Thakur's life. He was the living legacy of his signature. Saraswati Thakur lived all his life like this. Although he was a big scholar, he always repeated, Vidyar Gaurave Brahmi Deshe Deshe Thana Upajana Kore. On the power of material education, people end up becoming very dull-headed, Saraswati Thakur said. He said, this is why I learnt more from Gaur Kishore Das Babaji than from my astronomy classes. How did he live his life? By the mercy of that wonderful, unbroken legacy, golden legacy of our Gaudiya Parampara, we got our Prabhupada, who was inspired by that Saraswati Thakur. And Saraswati Thakur, inspiring the whole world, finally, during his last days, was constantly chanting the Govardhana Vasa Prarthana Dashakam of Raghunath Das Goswami, worshipping Govardhan, thinking of Govardhan, just like our Prabhupada. Our Prabhupada in his departure days would tell Tamal Krishna Maharaj, I want to go on a Govardhan Parikrama, just like my Gurudev. And Tamal Krishna Maharaj would say, it's not possible. So can you do it on my behalf and give me the credit? Prabhupada used to beseech. So in this way we see both Saraswati Thakur and our Srila Prabhupada very attached to Govardhan in their departing days. And finally, on the 1st of January 1937, Srila Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur wound up his manifest pastimes, and as he left, all the wall clocks of the Gaudiya Math stopped at the same time to mark the time, the departure time of a great Acharya going back into the eternal pastimes of Radha and Krishna as a maidservant. Nayana Mani Manjari. How beautiful is this day. Today, although we are separated 82 years from the departure anniversary, the actual date, if we resonate in the consciousness, we can imagine that we are actually in the presence of all the wonderful disciples of Srila Prabhupada, Saraswati Thakur, who witnessed the passing away of Prabhupada Saraswati Thakur. So, our Prabhupada would say that I am very lenient with you. If you had my Gurudev, you will be finished by now. How merciful to be under the auspices of our Srila Prabhupada. So on this most auspicious, wonderful departure ceremony of the Viraha Mahotsava of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, we thank Saraswati Thakur for giving us our Prabhupada. Jadi Saraswati Thakur no hoito, tabe ki hoito. How would we have got Srila Prabhupada? So in that connection, connecting Saraswati Thakur to his father, Srila Gaur Kishore Das Babaji Maharaj, spiritual father, and his son, Abhay Charana Aravinda, Bhakti Vedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, these three generations, we worship them through thought, word, and deed. Hare
Krishna. Shanti, shanti, shanti.